Maybe it's 3 a.m. Had you on my mind, and it's not the first time we've gone through this.
Random Measure is one of our channel. See our movie. Today we're gonna be. I'm gonna be talking about my opinion and my honest review of Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. So yeah, obviously I gotta play some of the beta. I didn't play that much because I kind of gotta prioritize my time over the weekends because now I don't know if I told you guys I do have a job now and I'm back in school and it's online school. There's a whole lot more assignments I gotta be doing. I gotta really prioritize my own time there. I'm not doing too well with that, but yeah, So it's kind of hard for me to get content and stuff. And since I'm a teenager, I really can only work on the weekends right now. So I have to work on the weekends, which is when the alpha was out. It was out on Friday too, but on the weekend I didn't really get much time to play. So on Saturday night I kind of woke up at like 12 o'clock, couldn't go back to sleep, so I decided I'm gonna hop on Cold War, and I just started grinding my ass off on it, didn't stop playing. And some of these gameplays I actually did really, really good on. So yeah, let me just get into my review. The game is a lot of fun. So far, there is some little nitpicky things that you could work on that they might want to work on, fix for when the actual game comes out. But that's what you expect from an alpha, obviously, because it's not even the beta yet. It's not even the full game. So yeah. But for it being an alpha, we're really good, and there seems to be a really close to being full game, and then like we're gonna have a lot of fun. But so I had a lot of fun personally. The gameplay, the gunfights, the gunplay, it's all really nice. It feels like a good combination, good balance of like back to Black Ops 4, but also a good combination of Modern Warfare, so it's like some really good gunplay. The movement is kind of interesting to get used to though, because yeah, it is a lot like Modern Warfare, but there's also that Treyarch aspect to it, so it feels a lot like Black Ops 4. And then you have that higher health, so the time to kill is a little bit longer than it was in Modern Warfare. Modern Warfare's time to kill is insanely quick, and then on Cold War it's a lot slower. It's a lot closer to Black Ops 4 time to kill, because there's 150 health again. Just know that you don't have to do the manual health regen anymore. And then, yeah, there's also some things like some certain guns are way too overpowered for this to be already that overpowered. Like the 74U, it's already a meta weapon, and that's insane for there to be a meta weapon already when the game's not even out yet, or we don't have a beta, and it's not like a full week we get to play it. It's just, we had it for a weekend, and it was an alpha, and there's already meta weapons. Like you have the 74U, the M16, and the XM4, those are all really, really good guns. The AK-74U, probably one of the best out of them. They can outgun at range. It can outgun at range. The AR should only be able to outgun our snipers or the tactical rifles. And it's insane that those are that broken. That it's that broken. And then I was kind of disappointed, because the MP5 is actually not as good as I was hoping it to be, because it's an MP5. And normally those things are really good in Call of Duty games. And like, I'm really bummed about that part. But yeah. So the 74U definitely needs to be nerfed and worked on, and then the M16, it's a one-burst machine. At certain distances, you can one-burst people, and that's just fucking insane, and you shouldn't be able to do that. The snipers also are getting nerfed, I'm pretty sure. The sniper gameplay is actually kind of weird, in my opinion. It's kind of like Modern Warfare, but also it's its own little thing. The way you slide in the sniper rifle and scope in was a little interesting for me. I had to get used to it. I'm not the biggest fan of the sniping in the game so far. It is fun and is very intuitive and very easy to get used to, but I'm just not the best at sniping, so I didn't really do too good. And then the XM4, or the Commando from Black Ops, is also in here. It's decently good, not as bad, or not as OP as the 74U, but it is also really good. So, yeah. And then, a thing that was a big problem that a lot of people got pissed about is there is obviously already skill-based matchmaking in this alpha. There was already skill-based matchmaking. A lot of people were upset about that. They don't want skill-based matchmaking. Now, to an extent, I think skill-based matchmaking is a thing you need, but also to an extent, I think it isn't there, because you give the bad players a false hope because they get matched up with people just as bad as them, and then they feel like, oh, they're really good at the game, and then you get them false hope, and it's all this mumbo-jumbo. So skill-based matchmaking is kind of annoying, and as long as it's not as bad as Modern Warfare, I'm gonna be okay with it, mostly, because Modern Warfare skill-based matchmaking, holy shit, puts you in a different game every single game, after every single match, because they want to match you up with people of your skill level. Like, that is the dumbest stuff ever. It just shouldn't work that way. So, and it really influences reverse boosting too, where people that are really good at the game will just sit there and like get really like five shitty games in a row and get put in a lobby with a bunch of noobs, and then they just go the fuck off. So yeah, if it's like that, it's a big deal. So yeah. A lot of the game is just little things that need to be fixed. Skill-based matchmaking, we'll see. It's obviously going to stay in the game. They're not getting rid of it. And there's some little things we also found out that it looks like prestiges might actually be in the game, and it might be the normal leveling system back from Black Ops 4 instead of what we had instead of the officer ranks in Modern Warfare, which would be fucking amazing if we could get those back. It looks like there are the normal challenges we had from kind of from BO4, the same type of challenges in there. There was just some stuff because like it was a glitch with the score streak challenges where if you shoot on score streaks you used to get the challenges unlocked. There's people that would like the thing with your level icon that changed depending on how much you played the game and how much you leveled up, and it actually had the level icon and people managed to get all the way up to the prestige 1. So it looks like there's going to be prestiging in the game, which would be fucking amazing. I would love to have that back. I'll grind a master prestige finally for once. Like, I could actually have the opportunity to do that on a new COD, so that'd be really nice. And yeah, so I might be posting some other gameplays today, like, because I still have some gameplays left over from the alpha that are actually pretty good. So I'll probably post those, and yeah, hope you guys enjoy the video. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out, and goodbye.
Stay dripped to the feet, night ticks on fleet. Fuck with it, fuck me, fuck shorty, fall free. Ain't no killers, I'm just killing all these beats. Ain't no killers, I'm just killing all these beats. Stay dripped to the feet, night ticks on fleet. Fuck with it, fuck me, fuck shorty, fall free. Ain't no killers, I'm just killing all these beats. Ain't no killers.